Hello and welcome back everyone. So here I am at the day when the war has broken out. So if we go at the political but diplomacy map mode, I guess, and then you can see that the red indicates territory which is controlled by a nation which is at war with war with us. And I would like to just summarize before I do anything that what is my general plan. Here is the victory point condition of Poland. As you can see, Danzig, Lodz, Krakow, Warsaw, Lvov and Grodno. These are having victory victory points, and this means that all of these victory points has to be captured by me or by one of my allies, or by any other nation actually, and the one who captures the capital can actually annex the nation. So let's see what is the general plan. I think I will here push forward with from the south and capture Krakow. So this is easily done quite fast. Danzig is an easy one. You can just capture it very fast. And the other actually Lodz as well is quite close to the front line, so not so very hard. However, Warsaw in English, I think it's pronounced Warsaw. Then this is an urban territory, which means that it's some harder to fight. To attack it. Especially for armored units and for motorized units, while other two, Lvov and Grodno, they are far away, so it might take a while. And I think the Soviet Union actually doesn't attack, I believe, Poland in this case. Just you have to pass them the territory, or I'm not sure. I will see. I don't remember really that part. So, but my plan is that from the south we'll push forward. And first of all, these units will support. I will send forward this army, and the mountaineers. The Hungarian army is a support attack. This ensures that we have, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4 provinces from which we are attacking or supporting from. Which is very important. The more angles of attacks there are, the more efficient your attack will be. In this case, however, in Chestokova, or I don't know how it's pronounced, in this province, we don't have too much choice. We can only attack from a single direction. In the Danzig's case, I think I will send these two motorized units. To Danzig. This ensures first of all they capture this victory point here. Second, in case the Polish would attack, which I think they will try to attack my units in East Prussia, then I can keep this corridor open in case there is some need to retreat. Also, I can counterattack these units in these provinces from multiple directions if I take Danzig. So. Yes, and this will be the main push, this side. And 18 divisions, which with an HQ, which we do have, means that this will be just within the general's command limit, because general can normally command 9 divisions, but with an HQ it doubles to 18. But actually, I see that we have a field marshal here, so this is with HQ, this means that this. For Falkenhausen could actually command 24, so it would not be probably even if I had a couple of more. I will push forward towards Radom and towards Warsaw, and attempt to get that. And a few of these units will actually not go towards Warsaw, but they will go to Radom and capture Lodz. Another few of these units. For example, these ones, they will just go to Radom and they will support attack Warsaw. This is that I want to prevent the Poles being able to cut off my armies attacking Warsaw. In the north, I send those units over there. I will attack this province, which I cannot pronounce. It's quite difficult for me to pronounce the name of that one. These units I not use for attacking because I believe that they will be attacked by the Poles. And now I have the air force to allocate. So So this is all the Air Force which I have, and plus the Hungarian ones, which I'm not sure if I use or I'll set it up later. So first of all, the ones in Königsberg should use interdiction in this region. And then 1 month should be enough. I don't think that really a lot of enemy aircraft will come, but in case there is some, it doesn't really matter. I'm not really afraid of the Polish Air Force. Then from Berlin, I can actually support Warsaw with the tactical bombers. I mean, support my units going there with the tactical bombers. And I have some lag now, I think it's fraps. Okay, so let's see if it is better now. I'm back. Yeah, so I will use my tactical bombers to support this region over here. And use interdiction that they attack actually enemy's organization, so that I have a higher chance of winning battles. And because of the... In this case, I don't really care about enemy strength, so I don't want to ground attack them, because I'm supposed to just push through them. And also send these interceptors here for air superiority mission against enemy air force. And select a region, because I want them to go around, I mean a bigger area, basically. Try to get enemy fighters and enemy airplanes. Okay. Actually, I fixed this problem which I had in the first few episodes with Fraps' resolution, because I apparently it recorded this game in a pretty bad resolution. This might have been the reason why now I have issues with it, but it seems to be now okay. Okay, so what else do we have here? We have a couple of, actually not a couple, a lot of closer support, which I will send for interdiction missions all over the front line. In this case, I said keep the default, I think, one month mission limit, because I don't believe that this entire campaign, Polish campaign, will take too much. Also, you are supposed to pay attention to the command limit of your air generals as well. Here I have lieutenant generals which can command actually 8 squadrons, so I don't send more than 2 groups to the same area. This last one, I think I will send them to this area here. Okay, we also have the Hungarian Air Force, not too much. I will send them to air superiority over this region, in case the Poles would attack. And at the same time, we must not forget that we are also at war with the Western, France and England and their allies in the West. Okay, sorry for that, I am back. And so I wanted to say that in the West I had to set up actually all my forces for protecting my German industrial areas. Now in this case I will select a region so that they go all over Germany, which is within their range, and select this sign for this one here for a continuous, I mean forever mission time, at least until I shut them down. And I think that in Arsenal Democracy actually you can do that easier. You can just maybe right click, yeah, somewhere, and give the comments to multiple units at the same time. Okay. So I believe that we are. This is good. So everyone is knowing what to do. And I'm thinking that I could also do something different here. Yeah, I think this is what we do. I will split this Hungarian army into two and use one to support attack Krakow, just to get this additional angle, and use the second one to push forward. And use this Hungarian army in Prešov to push actually to Lvov, so that I can capture this victory point fast. And I now set the speed somewhat lower, like normal, and I will unlock the time. I mean, start the time. And let's see what is going on. So a lot of battles actually start. And we do have some enemy aircraft attempting to disrupt my bombers, but my interceptors have caught them, and they are pretty outdated models, so they don't really pose a threat. Also, it seems that the France is trying to bomb my units, which is not so big problem. I don't care about that. It would be worse if they try to bomb my industry. Yes, and Danzig has been captured. Here I'm having some air battles. I'm shooting down some British strategic bombers. And all the battles seem to be going really well against Poland. Even the Hungarians are doing pretty well, it seems. Yeah, this is maybe the weakest point of my assault over here, but I think this will succeed most likely. And it seems that Poland didn't attack me, which is very good, because I can do then something else. I might be able to push through here. First of all, I will support attack this province over here, that they can push through faster. And I'm thinking about sending these units to Grodno to actually capture the victory point very fast. My army... So this event actually is about preparing to go to war against Denmark and Norway, which I will go with the historical decision. And so my army is doing really well over here, and I think I might be able to capture Warsaw very fast, as well as Lodz. Meanwhile, we send over these mobile divisions to Königsberg, and they will advance towards Grodno. They will be supported by these units here in Königsberg. And my mobile units are advancing to Warsaw and to Lodz as well. Krakow is as well soon in my hands, which means that the Polish campaign is soon over. I'm just having a look at that. The French indeed did mass divisions on the border in Strasbourg, which means that I have to set a few of these units as reserves. Reserves, actually, they are in a province where they are stationed, but they can quickly come to aid any neighboring province in case this province is attacked, which is very good. I am actually most worried about Freiburg. This is a plains. I think this is plains terrain. Yes, which means that it doesn't provide any additional defense. There is some very low level 1 fort there, and there is a river, but there is here two enemy provinces, and there is a total of 23 divisions. So they could be really dangerous to these units here, and I don't want the French to push through my defenses at all. Okay, it seems that also Lodz is putting up some sort of resistance. And they counterattack my units in this province with B, which I cannot pronounce. Okay, let me see what is going on. This unit here should go and... I will send it to Grodno. I guess they get there faster. This is all plains provinces, so it should be really fast to pass through. Warsaw has been captured by von Manstein. And the Poles counterattack, but I don't think that they will succeed. I will do another push to Poznan for two reasons, both to get that province and to eliminate the units inside there, which I think that I will capture Lodz beforehand, so they will be destroyed when they try to retreat. And also to ease the pressure on those units in this province with B. Okay. Yeah, but these units are holding up. They are also newer models, and I have better leaders and better doctrines. So I think this will be really fast. This might be a problem that this actually is in Hungarian hands, because when I annex Poland, Hungary will get this province. Okay, the Soviet Union has taken its half of Poland, so as I remember, there was no fight here, but it's an automatic event, basically. And now I believe that I can annex the remainder, because all the victory points is in my hand. Which is very good. I will stop everyone. And I can reorganize my forces now. I want to send most of the units, a couple of units will go, especially mobile units, to... I think it's... Lübeck, yes. To Lübeck as well, and to Kiel, to push through Denmark. My mountain units should definitely go to Rostock for the future invasion of Norway, and I will leave a few infantry units here in the east. These three divisions in Königsberg, I will leave them there. The mobile units will be redeployed immediately to the western front. Yes, these two will be redeployed immediately. All the air units, I don't need any more air units in this area, so at least for a while. So I can redeploy units. Tactical bombers will go to Kiel to help in the invasion of Denmark and Norway. As well as one interceptor group. The rest of them, the closer support, should go to Essen. I want them to rebase only, not to do anything special. That might have to do it one by one. So these records should reorganize and should prepare for the upcoming attack against... A few of them will be sent to Wilhelmshaven. So that attack against the Low Countries and France. And let's see what kind of other... I think the Hungarian units will be used to protect the front line now, and I will redeploy most of these units to the western front. Especially along Cologne. I mean, to that these provinces around Cologne. Saarbrücken, Cologne, Aachen. And a few will be sent to the provinces neighboring the Netherlands. And let's see what else do I have. Yes, these ones will be sent here up. Wilhelmshaven and Münster. And soon I will have a few more garrisons which I can deploy to the Polish captured Polish areas, which will be really important. The Hungarians should take care of the border protection for now. And I will keep one army in Budapest to protect the capital of Hungary from any possible attacks from any neighboring countries. I believe that soon the Bulgaria and Romania might be able to join the Axis, which is very nice. And now I unlock the time. And I see that all units have indeed taken their new positions. So we are preparing for invasion of Denmark and Norway. This is the next step. And also preparing for invasion of France. And you can see more and more divisions are massed in the border provinces of France. Which is dangerous in case they want to push through these defenses here, because especially Freiburg, as I mentioned, is really vulnerable. But now, as I'm redeploying my forces, I'm not so much afraid of this. And also, in the other hand, it has a good thing. Advantage to me is that these are mostly, infantry divisions, means slow divisions, not mobile units. Which means that if France actually messes most of her army to these three provinces here, then if I can push through fast enough just behind them in the Ardennes, in this forest area where the historical Germany went through, then I can encircle them and I can bypass them and get fast to the capital and basically defeat France without having to lose a lot of people, a lot of men. And this is the historical event for honoring the pact basically with the Soviets, which I will go with the historical choice. They got back that province over there. I don't really care, so I just sent this Hungarian army over here. I don't think the Soviets should attack soon. They might attack if you wait for a long time, but not just yet. Also, we still have with them non-aggression pact. Yes, it is. I also deployed, just you could see, a garrison division to Warsaw. This is because I want to first to deploy to the high industrial capacity areas and potentially important areas, as well as areas which are hard to conquer back. I don't like, for example, to lose urban areas to partisans, because the urban modifier is pretty bad for attackers. So it's somewhat harder to get it back, so this is why I just put the garrison division, so they should both decrease the chance of partisan uprising, and if it happens, then it should fight it and defeat them, hopefully. So I'm really having some trouble with traps. I don't really understand now what is going on, because my computer should be able to handle that. I guess it has to do with the fact that now I'm recording on better resolution. But anyway, I will figure it out after this episode, hopefully. Meanwhile, a couple of new divisions have been finished, and I will deploy those. Also, I wanted to deploy some more transport ships here, because these three will definitely not be enough. I think I will deploy three more. Also, I don't like to fill completely my transport navies with soldiers, because in case some of those transport ships get sunk, then it is full, then you will lose the division. While if you have free space, then I think you will not lose it, but it will be considered that that was the empty one, and your army will be safe in the other one, actually. Let me have a look at the production statistics. We are repairing our provinces. These are the provinces which we captured from Poland, because I think that really the British couldn't really bomb Germany proper, because my interceptors are doing a really good job now. Okay, and I think I speed up some of the time, because now there's nothing to do at the moment. I'm just waiting my units to redeploy. And I believe I have to declare manually war on Denmark and Norway, but I'm not really sure about that. I don't remember that part. So the Hungarian armies have taken their positions, most of them. There's one still being redeployed to protect against the Soviets in case anything happens, but I don't think that they will attack now. Let me have a look at Japan. The Chinese theater, and I see that nothing has happened, so the front is kind of static at the moment, which is I would really like if Japan could finish off China, then a lot of her forces could be freed up to eventually fight the Allies and maybe the Soviets as well. Also, China can produce a lot of infantry, which is very, very useful for Japan. So let me have a look at the situation here in the western border. So we have four divisions in Wilhelmshaven, four in Münster. I might want to switch these divisions so that the one with the HQ is in the middle, so it can have effect on both its own province and neighboring provinces. And the one without the HQ can be on the flank, which doesn't really matter. Yes, Dortmund has 5 divisions, which from it 2 is mobile, and Aachen has 13. There's an HQ here, which is very good, and only 3 mobile divisions, maybe a few more are being deployed. No, not any, no more. Okay, the French don't attack in the Freiburg, Saarbrücken, Stuttgart area, which is again very good. They don't have to keep their keep forces there. I have here 21 divisions in Cologne, and 3 HQ, which is too much. I think I will be able to send one more somewhere else, although I don't really need them there, so I will keep these numbers. These number of units might be not enough, I think. But if you think about it, you want to push through these countries. I'm also not sure if I want to attack the Netherlands immediately or only later, because this would mean that I will have to keep, I mean, basically have a wider front. The enemy has more chance to reorganize and more time, which I don't want. Best would be to push through here Bastogne, Arlon, Reims, and after head directly to Paris. This is basically, and another army basically could go southwards and attempt to encircle these units in the border area. And this is, I think, what I will try to do, but I believe that I will not attempt it right now. I will wait until next year in the spring. And hopefully until that I get some of my armored units ready. Also, here there are a couple of divisions, 21, which I can redeploy most of these once I finish Denmark and Norway. So I think I will now declare war on Denmark. Again, I'm not sure if this is done automatically by an event, I don't remember, or not. I will move my navy, which is not very big, in this area. And I simply just push through these. I mean, I don't see really that there is... okay, you cannot go... Yes, from Lübeck you can go, actually. And also I will send these tactical bombers to help. Again, I choose interdiction because I don't want anything but just to push through these units. And once that is done, I don't really care what is... I mean, really, that this small country is finished. Ground attack, if I'm correct, at least it used to be... Okay, so this has been finished. Denmark has surrendered. Yeah, so ground attack actually is... If I'm right, then it targets the strength of the enemy unit, while interdiction targets the organization of it. So the second one is actually needed for winning battles. The first one actually is just to destroy physically the unit, wearing them down. But I don't really use the ground attack except in situations like against the Soviet Union, where you just want to, when you have a chance, you just want to really to get rid of the units. I mean, destroy them physically completely. Otherwise, in small countries, you just want to push through and capture vital areas, and for that, interdiction is better. And now I have the chance to load actually a few of these units into transport ships. As I said, I will load only 5 into the 6 transport ships. So even if one gets sunk for some reason, then I still have enough. I still have, one more slot which where the units can go, and then they will not be lost, I believe. And I set up these tactical bombers here. And so I set up these tactical bombers here to support Norway. I mean, support my units in Norway, not Norway, of course. And once I'm close, I will declare war, and I will immediately land in Oslo. First armored divisions are ready to be deployed. It's very good. really waiting for these. There we go to the Köln Cologne area. Also, I redeployed these mobile forces here. And I send a few infantry divisions just to key strategic locations. Problem is that all these provinces have actually beach, beaches, which means that the enemy can land here if they want. Which makes me have to pay attention to this. Once more Grayson divisions will be ready, I will send a few to these provinces. I send now one to Copenhagen, one I think it was a garrison division. Okay, that's very good. Because since I'm controlling now this strait, no one can come through this strait. So Rostock is not in danger at the moment. Okay, so my ships have arrived. So I'll declare war on Norway, not now, but next day at around 4 o'clock. So I can immediately start attacking in the morning. Declare war and my units are just at the border. I will order the Kriegsmarine and these few ships which I have to bombard the shore of Oslo. Okay. And I will send the transport ships to actually attack it. Yeah, I'm really having some serious trouble with these traps this time. So I send the transport ships to actually do an amphibious assault over Oslo, and let's see what happens. You can see we are pushing through the defenses very fast, and my modifiers are not so bad. You really don't want to attack with too many divisions in case of an amphibious attack, but this is not really a serious defense which they have there, so I'm okay. Also, my bombers are very useful. And there is some naval battle there, which I will put. I will set this to display and pause. I want to see those naval battles definitely. But this is, yeah. I just obliterated those ships. So Oslo is done, captured. I will withdraw, not yet, but I will soon withdraw my navy from there, because I don't want to encounter the stronger British navy. Also, I will transport a few more mountain divisions to Norway, but I might immediately go to Narvik. Yeah, I think this is what I will do. I will attempt to attack directly from Narvik. This means that I have to here promote or set some lieutenant general at least, or maybe general. I'm thinking about actually I want these to level up, so I think I will set a general in command of one of these divisions, possibly with offensive doctrine if I find one. This one is very good. So yeah, I want to do that because most likely they will have at least one division in Narvik as well, so I need to amphibious assault it, and I have here four divisions which I want all of them to be used in the attack, and this requires at least a general to do without serious stacking penalties. So I send the transport ships to amphibious assault, and once this navy here has finished that few Norwegian ships, then I will send those as well over there for both protection as well as shore bombardment. Shore bombardment actually gives you a little bit of positive modifier against the enemy, or rather gives maybe the enemy a negative modifier against you, but in any case it helps you to overcome enemy defenses in a province with beach where you can actually land. Yeah, I said this shore bombardment, and let's see the battle how it goes. If they won, then I can annex Denmark, and it was really very fast and very efficient. Not a lot of lives have been lost, and they definitely did won. The British are nowhere to be seen, which is very good. Most likely they are too confused with what has happened so far. I will deploy these divisions into... into Aachen. But... yeah, they did it some stupid way. I told you, you want to really keep separately the armored divisions from the... I mean, mobile divisions from the less fast divisions. And also think that I will keep these mountaineers in Norway stationed there. Don't really need them anywhere, and it's a mountainous terrain. If in case the British would try to attack, then it would be a nice defense. Also, I encountered a couple of Norwegian ships, but they send no chance against me. I will at this moment annex Norway, not sue for peace, but rather annex. Just misclicked. Yes, that's right. And immediately send out a few divisions to all the provinces where enemy might land. All of these provinces actually unfortunately have beaches, which are very bad, except these two uppermost provinces, northernmost provinces. I will keep two divisions in Narvik because it's an important area. Send one over these provinces. I will rebase my tactical bombers to reorganize somewhere close to the to the western front, the Low Countries and France. I didn't choose to rebase to Essen because Essen has already a lot of airplanes, and these have longer ranges, so they can still target the most likely areas. But in case they are damaged or they need to reorganize, then it happens faster, because this air base is already overcrowded, in my opinion. There's a lot of air forces here, I mean air units here in Essen, the 12 squadrons, and this means that this level 4 air base is not cannot keep up with that many air units. I will send back my fleet to some safe port, to Rostock, and send a few more of these mountaineers to neighboring, to close Norwegian shore provinces to prepare against possible enemy attacks. I mean, I'm afraid that the Brits will try to do something. And this province is actually not protected, which is bad. I don't know what to do with those. I don't have now any free divisions to station there. Maybe I could try to... yes, I just try to keep only one single division in Oslo. Because anyway, these one nearby can help if in case there is a problem. I mean, an attack happened. Okay, I think that this is it for this episode. Thank you for watching. I apologize for the problems with fraps. Last time, or the first few episodes, it was the resolution. Now it was this slowdown, which I don't understand really why is happening. I'll try to figure that out, and I will see you next time.